The first man-made glasses were produced more than 4,000 years ago. Somehow, craftspeople worked out that if you can melt sand, you can make glass. Glass was a new material, and the whole melting technology had to be invented from scratch. Sand melts at a very high temperature. In order to melt the sand, one needs to bring the temperature down as far as possible. And for that, one adds a substance known as a flux. Fluxes reduce the melting temperature of another material. In the case of glass, one of a number of alkaline substances were used as the flux. You actually need a third ingredient, and that is in some form calcium, because that stabilizes the glass. But to the best of our knowledge, in the ancient world, no one knew of that property of calcium, and the calcium got into the raw materials of the glass more or less by accident. In front of us is a model of half an ancient Egyptian glassmaker's furnace. What the glassmaker did was to take the raw materials, the sand, the flux, and the accidental lime, put them in small bowl-shaped crucibles, rest the crucibles on ledges inside the furnace, light a fire in the bottom of the furnace. In time, the raw materials melt. The furnace is allowed to die down, and eventually, when everything is cool, the crucibles are removed, and instead of the powdery raw materials, they now contain cake-shaped ingots of glass. Now, those ingots are just the first stage in creating ancient Egyptian glassware. The glass maker has made the material glass. An entirely different group of people turn that material into objects, and not only in Egypt. We know that glass was an expensive trade item, and if we walk over to the right and look at the screen, what we're seeing is the underwater excavation of a Bronze Age shipwreck that was discovered off the coast of Turkey. Pause for long enough to look at some of the things being discovered. They are ingots of glass. They are exactly the same size and shape as the ingots in our ancient Egyptian furnace.